Dear students, in this lecture, I will cover the calculations regarding delta O, B and beta that are applications of Tanabe-Sugano diagram. They are the main application of Tanabe-Sugano diagram is that they are helpful in the determination of crystal field splitting energy, rec parameter and Nephelauxetic ratio. So how we can calculate these three special values with the help of this Tanabe-Sugano diagram. There is no difficulty in calculating the delta O value for four configurations that are D1, D6, D4 and D9. So in case of these four configurations, as we know that there is possibility of only one transition because the ground state term in both cases it is ND and maybe 2 or maybe 5 or there are two states. Sorry, this is EG. This term is EG. So there are two states T2G. In case of D1 and D6, T2G is the ground state and EG will be the excited state. While in case of D4 and D9, EG is the ground state and T2G is the excited state. And we already know that the difference between T2G and EG set is known as delta O. From crystal field theory, we know that the difference between T2G and EG is delta O. So crystal field splitting energy in case of these four configurations can be easily calculated, can be easily evaluated as if we have given the transition energy of this transition, then that will be the delta O value. If we have given that the transition energy in from N to T2G to EG is this much, then that will be the delta O value. So we have not to calculate any delta O value. So delta O value is nothing but it is the difference between these two energy states. So for D1, D6, D4 and D9, it is very easy to calculate the value of delta O. This is the Tanabe-Sugano diagram for D3 and D8 configuration. The only difference is that there is the multiplicity may be different. In case of D3 or D8, the multiplicity may be 3 or 4. In case of D3, it is 4 and in case of D8, it is 2. So the diagram will remain the same. The Tanabe-Sugano diagram is like this. So if we have given the transition energy, there may be the possibility of three transitions. This may be the transition, this may be transition and this may be the transition. So there are the three possibilities of transitions in its spectra. So if we have given that this its energy is E1, its energy is E2 and its energy is E3. So if we have given E1 is less than E2 is less than E3, you can see that E3 is the it requires a large amount of energy, then E2 and then E1. So the order is like this. So if we have given these three transitions, then we can easily tell that which will be the delta O value. So delta O value will be nothing but it is the E1, that is the difference between this and this. So this is delta O. So if we have given three transitions, the lowest transition value will be the delta O value for D3 or D8 configuration. So it is very easy to calculate delta O for D1, D6, D4, D9, D3 and D8. So it can easily calculate. We have not to calculate any delta O value, but with the help of the given energy, we can easily tell about the delta O value. So in case of D3 and D8, as we see that the lowest energy difference will be the delta O value because this is the difference between A2G and T2G. We will understand later on when we see the configuration of D2 and D7 complexes. So this is the Tanabe-Sugano diagram of D2 and D7 configuration, and in case of D2 and D7 configuration, only the difference is the multiplicity of this F term and P term. So in this case, we can see that this is the lowest energy term, that is NT1G, and from NT1G to A2G and A2G, the difference is 1.8 delta O, while the lowest energy transition, that is from T1G to T2G, this difference is 0.8 delta O. So we can see that this lowest energy term is less than delta O and this highest energy term is more than delta O. So if we see the difference in between these two terms, that will be delta O. So the difference between this and this will be this and this. So the difference between these two terms will be 2T2G and T2G and A2G, that is equals to delta O. So we can see that in this case, in case of D2 and D7 configuration, it is not easy to calculate delta O. So in this case, the lowest energy term is 0.8 delta O. It is not delta O. So the difference between this and this, that is T2G and A2G, is the delta O. So I can explain you why this difference is delta O. If we see in this transition from here to here, in this transition, the involvement of T1G term. This transition is from T1G to T2G, this transition is from T1G to T1G, and this transition is from T1G to A2G. So any transition that involve T1G, that will not be helpful in calculating the value of delta O. So we have to seek those terms, those transitions, where there is no involvement of T1G term. So only one transition is there, that is the difference is that T2G to A2G, this difference is, there is no involvement of T1G. So this difference is delta O. So why this occur? So in this case, T1G, as we know that from correlation diagram, we know that T1G and this T1G both have the same multiplicity. They are of same symmetry terms. They are same symmetry term. This is generated from P. This is from F. They may be far. They may be near, as in case of D3 and D8 configuration, they are near. But in this case, they are far. But because they have same symmetry, so they mix. They have tendency to mix. They mix, and after mixing, its energy will increase and its energy will decrease. Actually, they never cross each other. So there will be change in their energy. After crossing, after mixing, there will be change in their energy. So these cannot be helpful in calculating the delta O value. So where there is an involvement of T1G, it will not be helpful in calculating the delta O value. We can go to the previous configurations like D3 and D8. We can see that this transition, this lowest energy transition, that is from A2G to T2G, it is delta O because there is no involvement of T1G. This has involvement of T1G and this transition also have involvement of T1G. So the transition which do not have involved the T1G state, that will helpful in calculating the delta O. Likewise, in case of D1, D6 and D4, D9 configurations, we can see that it is T2G, it is EG. EG and T2G, no T1G. So those differences where no T1G is there, those will be helpful in calculating the value of delta O. I will give some examples, and then you can easily understand about the calculations of delta O. In case of D2 configuration, three transitions may be possible. This is the first transition of lowest energy. The energy is even. And for this transition from T1G to T1G of P, it is having the energy of E2. And the third transition is from T1G to A2G. So if we have given the value of E1 and E2, so we can see that these two transitions, these are the lower energy transitions. So if E1 is equal to 1720 centimeter inverse and E2 is equal to 25600 centimeter inverse. So for the calculation of delta O, first of all, we have to calculate the ratio of these two. So we will divide the greater value of E by the smaller value. So we will calculate E2 upon E1 or nu2 upon nu1. So we are calculating, this is the ratio of E2 and E1. So this is equals to, it is around 1.5. So if we get this ratio, then we can fit this ratio in the diagram. This diagram is prepared from, it can be prepared with the help of Tanabe Sugano diagram, where the ratio of energies, they are plotted against delta O upon B values. So this kind of curve can be obtained from Tanabe Sugano diagram when we plot the curve between E2 upon E1 and delta O upon B, and our delta our E2 upon E1 ratio is 1.5. So we can match this 1.5 at this y axis and then match this with the delta O upon B value, which is equal to 28. So at 1.5 E2 upon E1 value, the delta O upon B value is 28. Now we will take this value to the Tanabe Sugano diagram. So in Tanabe Sugano diagram, we know that this diagram is drawn between delta O upon B and E upon B. So we put this delta O upon B value at this x-axis, and then extrapolate this for this. This is the first transition and this is the second transition. So for first transition, we can calculate the value of E1 upon B. This is E upon B. So this energy difference is E1. So in Y axis, we can calculate or observe the value of E1 upon B. And by extrapolating it to the second transition, we will get the value of E2 upon B. So we will get two values, E2 upon B, that is equal to 39, and E1 upon B, that is equal to 26. So after getting these two values, we can calculate the value of B first. So as I already told that in case of D2 configuration, first we have to calculate B value, then with the help of this B value, we can calculate the value of delta O. So E2 upon B is equal to 39. E2 we already know, that is 25600 centimeter inverse. So B can be calculated. It is around 660. So if we calculate both the values, that is E1 upon B is equal to 26 and E2 upon B is equal to 39. So we can easily calculate the value of B. So for determining the delta O value for D2 configuration, we have to first calculate the value of B. Then we know that delta O upon B is equal to 28 and we know the value of B. So we can calculate the value of delta O, that is equal to 18480 centimeter inverse. So we can see that this value is in between the value of first transition and second transition. So this is the difference between these two transitions. So this is the delta O is equal to NT2G and NA2G difference. And again, I can summarize the calculation of delta O. So how we can calculate? If we have given two transition values, then we will first find the ratio of these transitions. So we will divide from greater value. We will find the ratio of greater value to smaller value, then we will get the ratio, that is E2 upon E1, and this E2 upon E1 can be put into the another plot, which is obtained from Tanabe Sugano diagram, and this is in between E2 upon E1 and delta O upon B, and from this we can get the value of delta O upon B that corresponds to E2 upon E1 value. Then this delta O upon B value can be put in the this Tanabe Sugano diagram of D2 configuration, and corresponding E1 upon B and E2 upon B values can be calculated, and this E2 upon B and E1 upon B can be used to calculate the value of B. So for this metal ion, the B value is near to cis, this is for complex ion, so this is for near 660. Now delta O upon B we already know, so we can calculate delta O value, and that is equals to 18480 centimeter inverse for this kind of ratio which we have been given. Then if we know delta O value, we can easily calculate delta T value, because delta T, this is crystal field splitting energy for tetrahedral complex, and it is equal to 4 upon 9 delta O. So if we know delta O, we can also calculate the value of delta T. And if we have given the value of B dash for complex ion, then we can easily calculate the ratio beta. So if beta B dash is given, so we can easily calculate the value of beta. So with the help of Tanabe Sugano diagram, we can easily calculate the value of beta if we know B dash, because we have already calculated the value of B for D2 configuration and delta O calculated, and this beta value. So these three value can be calculated from the Tanabe Sugano diagram. And for D3 configuration, that was the case of D2 configuration, and for D3 configuration, if we know the three transition value, transition energy values, then we can easily calculate the value of B. We can easily calculate the value of delta O, because if this is the lowest energy term, then this will be the value of delta O. And to calculate the value of B, this is the simple formula, that is 1 upon 15 E3 plus E2 minus 3 E1. It can be helpful in calculating the value of B for D3 configuration, where this E1 is the lowest energy, this then E2, then E3 is the highest energy transition. In case of D3 configuration, we can calculate delta O value and beta value with the help of this question. So this is an example how to calculate B, delta O and beta value for D3 configuration. So this is the question, that for CR F6 3 minus complex, 3 absorption band frequencies at 14900, 22700 and 34400 centimeter inverse, which correspond to nu1, nu2 and nu3 respectively. Calculate 10 dq, it means delta O, B and beta for this complex. Value of B for CR3 plus ion in free state is 918. So B has been given, we have to calculate B dash. This is complex ion, so if we calculate the value of B, that will be B dash, that will be for the complex ion. So first of all, we have to calculate, we have to see what will be the configuration of this ion. So in this complex, CR3 having the D3 configuration, so for D3 configuration, there is a formula, simple formula, that is 1 upon 15 E3 plus E2 minus 3 E1. So we will put the values. So this is the lowest energy level, this is the high medium energy level, and this is the highest energy level. So we can put, and easily we can calculate the value of B dash. And what will be delta O? So this will be the delta O, because this is the lowest transition energy. So we have not to calculate delta O value, but from the transitions, the lowest value transition will be the delta O value. So this is delta O, this is the B value, and we have already given the B value for metal ion. So B value for metal ion is 918. So beta will equals to, because it is the calculated value for complex ion, and this ratio is 0.90, which is less than 1. So it generally, it is the Nephelauxetic ratio, which is always less than 1, because the B value, rec parameter value of complex ion is less than that of a free metal ion. And the delta O is 14900 centimeter inverse. So in case of D3 configuration, it is very easy to calculate delta O, B and beta dash with the help of Tanabe Sugano diagram. The other problem that is related to Tanabe Sugano diagram is that CONH3 whole 6-2 plus has delta O value is equal to 10100 centimeter inverse and B is 920 centimeter inverse. How many electronic absorption do you expect to this complex? So we can easily calculate with the help of Tanabe Sugano diagram what will be the number of electronic transition for this particular complex if we have given delta O and B value. So first of all, we have to calculate delta O upon B value. So delta O upon B value is equal to 11, and in this complex CO is in plus 2 state, so it is D7 configuration. And for D7 configuration, if we recall this D7 configuration, the Tanabe Sugano diagram of this D7 configuration, we can see that the crossover point is at 22 delta O upon B value. So from this point, it towards its right, it is a strong field complex, and towards its left, it is weak field complex. So this is 22. Remember, this is 22, and R value in this question, it is 11. So 11 is present at the left side. So 11 is present on the left side of this 22. So this complex belongs to this category. It means if delta O upon B value is less than this 22, that is 11, so this complex is weak field complex, and if this value will be greater than 22, then this complex will be a strong field complex. So in this case, it is a weak field complex. Or in case of weak field complex, we can easily see that there is possibility of three transitions, and these three transitions are from 4T1G to 4T2G, from 4T1G of F to 4T1G of P, and 4T1G of F to 4A2G of F. So three transitions are possible if we have given the value of delta O as 10100 centimeter inwards and B value 920. So in this way, we can easily suggest about the number of transition of a particular configuration.